Some students are not there, ma'am.
Fine, let them come. See. Morning, everybody. I want everyone to put mute. Can you please put mute? See, today the session is all about corporate social responsibility, section 135. So last class we were discussing about this corporate social responsibility, that is operating the business by taking concern about the society and also the environment. Okay, so today we are going to see what and all the law comes under corporate social responsibility, which is under section 135. So corporate social responsibility la munnadi nam enna paathomna vandu or business operate pandranga, operate pannumbodhu avanga vandu society ku vandu enna welfare pandranga illa environment ku vandu enna welfare pandranga, that is avangalukku vandu endha naasamo agada mari avanga eppadi nadathuranga adha vandu அது வந்து கார்ப்பரேட் சோஷியல் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டியில வருது. ஸோ இஃப் யூ கேன் சி திஸ் டயக்ராம், ஓகே, ஸோ இன் திஸ் டயக்ராம் ஜஸ்ட் அஸ்யூம் தட் தெர் இஸ் அ கம்பெனி கால்ட் ஏபிசி கம்பெனி. ஓகே, ஸோ திஸ் ஏபிசி கம்பெனி யூனோ இஃப் ஐ மீன் த கவர்மெண்ட் வாண்ட் டு டூ சம் வெல்ஃபேர் டு த சொசைட்டி, ஓகே, ஸோ இட் இஸ் த ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டி ஆஃப் த கம்பெனி to do some welfare activity to the society. So for that, let's see the second one. This section 135 CSR, it has been implemented. Okay, so once you see this, this is like a proper session or a section of 135, which says that provisions requiring corporate to mandatory spend a prescribed percentage of their profit on certain specified area of social upliftment in discharge of their social responsibility, which means, let's come back to the diagram, which means when the company, for example ABC company, if they want to that is if they are getting more profit, so it is the responsibility of the company to contribute some percentage to society so that they can develop themselves. Okay, so that is what this section 135 says. As I'm reading again, provisions requiring corporate to mandatory spend a prescribed percentage of their profit, which means from the profit which a company is getting it from their end, they have to contribute. It is a mandatory. Okay, that is, it's a compulsory for a company to give or contribute some profit, that is some amount from the profit, and give to the society so that they can upliftment in discharge of their social responsibility, which means they can develop themselves. இதுல என்ன சொல்ல வராங்கன்னா வந்து கம்பெனிக்கு வர ப்ராஃபிட்ல இருந்து இது கவர்மெண்ட் என்ன சொல்றாங்கன்னா இது வந்து கண்டிப்பா வந்து அவங்களோட ப்ராஃபிட்ல இருந்து ஒரு பெர்சன்டேஜ் வந்து அவங்க வந்து சொசைட்டி ஆர் சோஷியல் வெல்ஃபேருக்காக இவங்க கண்டிப்பா வந்து கொடுத்து ஆகணும், டெலிவரி பண்ணணும், ஓகேங்களா, ஒரு அமௌண்ட். அதுதான் வந்து செக்ஷன் 135 சிஎஸ்ஆர் சொல்லுது. ஓகே, நெக்ஸ்ட் வி ஹாவ் விச் கம்பெனி இஸ் ரெக்வயர்ட் டு கான்ஸ்டியூட் சிஎஸ்ஆர் கமிட்டிஸ், தட் இஸ் ஹூ ஆர் எலிஜிபிள் டு ப்ரொவைட் அ சர்டன் அமௌண்ட் ஃப்ரம் தேர் ப்ராஃபிட் டு த சொசைட்டி. Okay, it is not like all the company have to give. So those company whose net worth of rupees 500 crores or more, turnover of just net worth of rupees 500 crores or more, turnover of rupees 1000 or more, net profit of 5 crores or more, I want everyone to switch on your video. I don't want anyone to disable your video. Onemani Selvan, Yogesh, please switch on your videos. Rachel, Bhuneshwari, Okay, those who are not switching on, I'm going to put absent for them. Okay, so coming back to the previous one, diagram. Okay, so when I say in ABC company, as I said, it is the responsibility of a company to contribute some profit. That is, from profit, they have to contribute some amount to the society. But it, who is going to take that responsibility? That is, you know, if you say a chartered accountant, no. Or any directors, no. So directors and a chartered accountant are not responsible to calculate the concerned profit amount and giving to the society. So in order to do that calculation, that particular committee has been formed. So when I say committee, you can see here who are the committee, CSR committee can be considered. So those company whose net worth of rupees 500 crores, that is a particular company's net worth is rupees 500 crores or more than that, then they will come under this CSR committee's category. Or turnover of rupees 1000 or more, that is turnover of rupees 1000, which means 1000 crores, okay, 1000 crores or more, then they are also eligible. Okay, or net profit of 5 crores or more. So if any of this eligibility criteria, if they are getting fulfilled, then they will come under CSR committee. Okay. Then we have
ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, Bavitra avangalukku signal kadaikka mattenda ma'am, avanga romba weak ah irukka.
Sari, okay, onnu prachana illa pa.
Okay.
Next we have composition of CSR committees, which means like who and are the people, as I said, a particular committee are the one who is taking the responsibility to do that calculation. Okay, so once they are done with the calculation from the profit, that is a particular percentage of the profit will be taken and then they will contribute to the society. Okay, so when I say committees, who and all will comes under this committees. Okay, for example, in government sector, okay, see in the first one you can say that composition of CSR company committees, who will comes under that? It shall be consisting of 3 or more directors, out of which at least one director shall be independent. What does that mean? It means, see, there can be 3 or more directors should be appointed within the organization, out of which at least one director shall be independent. Independent, it seems, it should be outside the organization. Okay, they can call from outside. So in government sector, they are following this one. Some sector company like unlisted public company or private company. Okay, so these people, you know, that is, if they are not appointing any independent directors, then there won't be any issue. It is not mandatory for unlisted public company or private company. As I said, it is mandatory for government company, one independent director. But for unlisted public company and private company, if you are not appointing any independent director, then there won't be any issue. If it is 2 directors, then also it is not a big deal. Okay. Coming to foreign company, if it is 2 person is operating that, out of which one shall be as specified in C-180-1D. This is a section, it is like section 180-1D. There's no need to go in depth, but it is like 2 director is enough for them. Okay, in under which, according to 180-1D, it says that there will be a time period to pay that particular debt from this foreign company, because due to transaction or converting the money kind of things or currency, it will take some time. So according to section 181D, 2 person is enough for them. Okay, and finally, the board of directors are the one who's going to disclose the composition of the CSR committee. That is, for one company, as I said, if it is a government company, three directors should be there. So that should be confirmed by a board of directors. Okay. And another one is like an unlisted public company or private company. For that, these people are, that is, board of directors are the one who is going to decide who is going to be in CSR committee. Okay. Next comes to amount to be contributed. See, as I said, overall committee has been made. Okay, now it is the committee to contribute some amount, as I said. Okay, that is profit which the company is getting, from that a certain percentage should be given to the society. So how that percentage can be calculated, that we are going to see here. Okay, see here. If you go to the first one, 3 year profit divided by 3 and 2% of total amount. That is, a continuous 3 years of the profit they are getting. For example, a company is getting profit from 2016, 17 and 18. Okay, so by calculating all this 3 profit divided by 3, okay, and that can be taken 2% of that. Okay, so if you take 2% of that overall profit, okay, that should be contributed to the society, that is to the government, and government will be given to the society. Okay, so this is what you're going to see here. See, in every financial year, company share spend at least 2% of the average. That is, 2% of the average should be taken for every financial year, or else NP, that is net profit of the company, more during the 3 immediate preceding year. So as I said, 2016, 2017 and 2018, which will the profit which they are getting from all these 3 years divided by 3. Okay, and then what and all the amount you are getting it, that will be divided by 2. Okay, so if you want me to show in detail. See here. For example, 2016, they are getting a profit of say 300 crores. 2017, they are getting say 400 crores. In 2018, they are getting a profit of say 500 crores. Okay, so how you're going to calculate this 300 plus 400 plus 500. Okay, so overall, how much you will get it? 1200, right?
Yes.
So in that you have to, yeah, 1200 divided by, okay, divided by 3, because 3 consecutive, that is 3 financial years. So how much you'll get it? 400. 400. Okay, so from this 400, you're going to take a 2% of that. So how much you're getting it?
8 crore.
8 crores. Okay, so this is how they're going to take this amount and they're going to contribute to the society. So this is what I was telling about. In every financial year, company's share spend at least 2% of the average net profit of the company more during the 3 immediate preceding year. Okay, so in case if the company fails to spend the board share, specify the reason for not spending the amount in its report. Suppose, as I said, we have told the committee to pay so and so percentage. In case if they are unable to pay it, then they have to tell the reason to the board of directors. Okay, in case even though without giving any information to them, or they are not disclosing any information to them, then what is the punishable, or what they are going to punish, or how they are going to punish? They will be punishable with fine. That is, company should pay 50,000 to 25 lakhs, and the officers who have helped them not to pay for that, then they have, that is, they will be in prison for 3 years, and they have to pay 50,000 to 5 lakhs. Okay. Then last but not the least, this following are not considered as a CSR activity. See, as I said that, okay, for CSR project or program, whatever you're doing it, they have to contribute something. But where they have to implement it, that plays an important role. So this CSR project or program should not taken. If you have written it as undertaken outside India, it's like not undertaken. Okay, so it should not undertaken outside India. Okay, it should be within India. Next one is, this project, program or activity benefits only the employees of the company and their family. It's like, it should not be in that way. That is, it should not only benefit to the employees, but also to the overall society. But when the company thinks that, okay, we are going to provide some benefits only to the employees or the company and their family, then they are not considered as a CSR project. Okay. And next is contribution of any directly or indirectly to any political party. It is for political party, they should not contribute directly to them. That is like kind of giving bribe to them, and they are taking this project or program as a CSR. So they are not considered as this kind of activity. Okay, so I hope you can understand what is the overall concept about this corporate social responsibility. So see, in the diagram, we can just have a summary about it. Okay, see, as I said, those who have not listened till now, please listen it properly once again. See, as I said, that a company, ABC company, when they want to, when they are earning more profit, so what the government say that it is the responsibility of that company to contribute some amount to the society for welfare activity. Okay. And next one is, after that, there won't be any CA or a director who is going to do directly to the, that is, welfare to the society. So in that case, what they have to do is, it is the responsibility of a committee. So who and all will comes under committee, which is, as I said, those whose net worth is like 500 crores or more than that, or 1,000 crores or more than that, or net profit of, say, what is that, 5 crores or more than that. So they are considered to be a committee. So this committee has to they have to make a profit, or like, you know, they have to calculate the profit. So when I say calculate the profit, how will it comes? Like, as I said, three continuous years, financial years, and divided by 3, and percentage of, that is 2% of that total amount will be taken. Those who are not paying for that, they will be giving fine. And second one is about, as I said, committee. Who and all will comes under committee is the directors, three directors. One is within, two directors who is comes under the company or more than that, and one director should be independent directors. Okay, that is for government company. And for non-government or public list company, they are the people where they can consider only dependent directors, no need for independent directors. So I hope you can understand this concept, right? Okay, so guys, who and all are absent today?
Ma'am, Pavitra avangalukkum connect aagalaya, Jagir avangalukkum connect aagalaya, Jansi avangalukkum connect aagalaya, signal problem.
Onnu prachana illa pa, connect aagrina namma idu pannikalam namma, adu onnu prachana illa, but enakku enna na ipo yaar unme varave illa.
Jagir mattum varala ma'am.
Illa Jagir vandane. Vandutte
connect aagalam.
கனெக்ட் ஆகல கனெக்ஷன்
வந்துட்டு போயிடு மேம் அது சிக்னல் சிக்னல் ரொம்ப வீக்கா இருக்கு அங்கெல்லாம்
அதனால யார் வரல அது மட்டும் சொல்ல சொல்லுங்க யார் வந்து அப்சென்ட் ஜான்சி புனேஸ்வரி எல்லாரும் வந்துட்டாங்க
ஜான்சி வந்துட்டாங்க மேம்